Hello everyone, welcome back to Prison Architect. Last episode we were taking a look at plans for expanding our prison to allow for prisoners to work in a workshop area for a change instead of being locked up in cells all the time. And it looks like our metal detectors are working. We found someone who needs to be searched. Here comes a guard, patting him down, checking to see if he's got anything illegal on him. Well, Edwards, have you done anything wrong? Well, they didn't find anything on you, so you got lucky this time. We are getting prisoners put into these holding cells, which is not really where we want to put them. We want them to actually go to regular cells. How are these trees? Are they mostly gone yet? Getting cleared out. Just logs left laying around, so since that is done, let's get our foundation set up. And I forgot to include the plans for the hallway, but that's fine. I remembered it just now, and while we are planning this out still, right here we will have a storage area. So, no, not actually right here. Right here, we're going to have a cleaning cupboard, which means that over here we will have our storage. Storage and exports, that is. See, we'll store here, we'll export here. Foundation, get those included in the design. Like so. Plans include the area for the doors. And for the entrance, we will take a jail door and put it there. Ah, look at our prison. It's looking nice and pretty until you get up here near the cafeteria, which makes it all look gross and disgusting. These janitors need to get to work faster, don't they? Oh well. Let's see, we're currently at a 36 prisoner limit. We will be two jail cells short of meeting our goal, so I think what I will do to compensate is include two jail cells down here. Both jail doors on. And let's jump up to double speed again. Oh yes, I forgot. I was gonna change the regime so that we eat at 11 and noon. And then some more free time there. And yeah, that'll work. They should be much more satisfied with their meals now. They won't be as grumpy, one would hope. While we're at it, let's take care of a few things that we've been neglecting. We've neglected to get a staff door put here. And we will need a new one placed right there. things are looking good. We should also designate that we want brick walls all around this empty area. And just a regular door right here. Since this area is currently locked off with the jail door, no prisoners should be able to get out here and mess things up, I would hope. It's very loud, being that close. So I think I'm actually doing a good job of getting a very functional-looking prison going. It's fairly compact. It's got plenty of room for expansion still. Maybe not in this general area, but in the future when we are able to expand our areas, wouldn't be too bad. And here comes the lights, which we will say, no, you cannot place those. I will let them purchase the lights, however, because we do need them. We will need them to install ourselves. Hey, dismantle that light. Weren't supposed to put it up. So now that we have a plan for the workshop, we do need to get a separate circuit for the heavy machinery, because those will use up a lot of power, and I don't want my power to be tied to a system that could trip everything and make it go completely dark in the jail, causing our prisoners to get upset and maybe even riot. We want to avoid the riots. By the way, have I neglected to put lights in this kitchen this whole time? I seem to have done that. Sorry, cooks. Didn't mean to force you to work in the dark. I'm sure that must not have been a pleasing experience. You've probably gotten several burns by now. Let's get another power station set up right here. Which we will use to that. Also, the thing that's getting our... And I have managed to trip the entire system. There we go. That should work. So yeah, it's a good thing I left the kitchen connected. Because we got someone being checked. And look at that, we're gonna have a prisoner actually leaving soon. It's an exciting day. Paul Rennie. Who's Paul Rennie? Let's see. Paul Rennie. There's Rennie. Yep, he is pretty much finished with his 1 year for dangerous driving. Good job, you stayed good. You did no bad. we're a model citizen, and let's see, Roddy Razzo. Have you got anything on you? Oh, you have tools? How did you get those tools? Well, good job. Now you get to go and sit in solitary confinement, which I have yet to actually assign. Here's your solitary confinement area. You get to sit in the sit outside, exposed to the elements, watching as everyone else gets to run around and play in the yard. I hope you are satisfied. So now that we have the clone tool, we actually are able to just copy a cell that we want to copy to use. And let's see, this is all closed off, so that's good. We can also declare a storage area, a new one, over here. This is where you guys get to store things now. I hope you're ready to move a lot of things, because we now are storing everything inside, currently in the dark. Who left Roddy Razzo's cell door open? Oh well. Let's see, materials, we need to actually demolish these walls. I'm going to demolish them as opposed to put a jail door on them, because it'll be easier for my guys to get in there and set up the object. We might as well get these cells set up ahead of time. We'll lock the doors open for now, because there's no need to have them shut. Some bookshelves, a couple of lights, and we're good. So how is this clone tool going to work anyway? Well, you'll get to see in just a moment what is happening in here. Why is there a bunch of... they're dumping food waste. I see. Look at my workmen go. And we have more prisoners than we can currently handle, so let's close our jail to accepting anyone new until we have these set up. Free time, people get to go watch TV, lounge on the couch, call their families back home, visit their visiting relatives, and time for supper. It's been a good run. We have had no incidents. Things have not exploded in our face. The prisoners have maintained low levels of aggression. All is going well. Almost too well. By the way, I should hire another guard now, because I kind of want to keep a 4-to-1 ratio, at the very least. Alright, so let's get this clone tool operating. To clone something, you simply select the clone tool, right-click what you want to copy, and drag a box. I cannot select any more than a 4x6 area for whatever reason, so I guess that'll suffice. And then you just place what you're trying to clone. And it will automatically take all the expenses away from setting up the entire thing. Ooh, we almost have our short-term investment completed. I still think that it bugged out when I saved and quit, because I swear it was only 32 hours when I saved, or something like that. I might have to double-check the video. does not clone is the utilities. So you have to remember to install these manually. Alright. Cells are almost finished. We just need to get the pipes in place, the doors slapped on in front of them, so that they cannot walk in and out. We'll set up a regular door right here. And in these areas. But up here, we will need a staff door on all of these. And I'll worry about getting the jail cell doors on the cells themselves. I am learning to speak English again. Sorry. We'll get the cell doors slapped onto these after all the pipes are in place and all the furniture is set up. Don't want to do it before then because it'll just make the job more difficult for my workers. By the way, these can go back to being normal. And we can declare them to be cells. Of which we can send two of our guys sitting in here to live out their lives in jail. And we have our short-term investment money back, so we can accept yet another grant. Let's see, prisoner acclimatization and engagement. That's the one that we are currently wanting to work on. Let's see. Let's worry about this one for now. As soon as we get the cell block B1 completed, we can worry about getting a crackdown on everything else. And while we are waiting, let's start looking into expanding the lab. Because I would like to get some more medium security stuff put into place. I could have a similar looking jail meant to be medium security. In fact, I could probably label this entire area here MinSec only. Yeah, I can. The yard MinSec only. It's visitation. This staff only will be for here. The morgue. This area. Offices. Well, not the psychologist's office. That will be a shared one. Maybe I should make it so that these are regular doors instead of staff doors. I'll think about it. But there we go. They are finished with the cells now. So let's get the jail doors put into place. Wow, these guys just got put into the cell without actually having a place to... a way to be locked in. Guards? Can someone explain that to me? Why are there prisoners in the cell when there's no door to keep them in the cell? I guess since they're minimum security, that's just perfectly fine. They stayed in there, they were good boys. Didn't have to worry about it. A lot of showering going on. I think I need to expand the shower so that more people can shower at once. So let's go ahead and start working on that. Let's see. Objects. there. A heck of a lot of shower space. We're going to need it. And we have finished our grant for expanding our capacity to 50. Next expansion would be to cell block C, which is 100 prisoners, which is kind of why I want to just copy this entire prison and make it a medium security area. I don't know how well that would work, though. I would need to see how much land we actually get as a result of buying another area before I can make that final decision. This one, I'm not too sure about doing. I think I'll take it, though. It probably is going to cause problems. Most likely, it definitely will cause problems. There we go. Shower heads are being installed. Yeah, I made this area slightly more cramped, but more people can get showered at once, so they should be happier overall as a result of that. Let's see. I need to get some lights in here. Bit of lag. I think we're going to have to stop recording soon. Yeah, I've been going for quite a while, so this is going to be the end of the episode. I hope you guys have enjoyed. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and fave, and I will see you next time. Take care, guys, and goodbye.